Hi, my name is Feiko Gorter. You can follow me on my website, feiko.io, where I blog and vlog. Also, I work for a company called Segeka, where I'm a senior Internet of Things consultant. And I'm also the creator of the WebSockets library for the .NET Nano Framework. So before we get started with an awesome demo I've prepared for you, what are WebSockets and why are WebSockets interesting? So I've looked up a page really quick for you that's explaining exactly what WebSockets are. WebSockets are a web protocol that's being used to have a bi-directional communication between client and server. So it helps you whenever you want to have a dynamic web page that is constantly updating, constantly showing new information. So let's get to the GitHub repository of the WebSockets implementation of Nano Framework. So as always, as everything with Nano Framework, everything is open source, and we have all documentation right here. As you can see, we implemented a WebSocket client and a WebSocket server, but for this demo, we're going to be concentrating on the WebSocket server, and we're going to be using this example right over here. So let's dive into the code, but before that, let's really have a quick look at the device we're going to be using for this demonstration. So if you see my device right here, it's an M5 stack ESP32. It's an Atom light and it has this very cool RGB LED. So you can change the color of the lightning. Also, it has very cool button over here and it's really cheap to have. So get out there and buy one because it's awesome. And we're going to be hosting a WebSocket server on top of this. So let's dive in into Visual Studio and see what this would look like. So here I have Visual Studio. I have all the code open. Here you see the program that's running on site is on the ESP32. And I want to really quickly show you what you need to do to get the WebSockets up and running. So here you see how the WebSocket server is initialized. You just see these optional WebSocket options. So we're going to say we only want to have a max of 10 clients because, hey, it's still a microcontroller. And also, it's not standalone because we are going to integrate this WebSocket server together with a web server. So if you want, you can also have it as a standalone version. And then we're going to have this event message received and hook it up to this event handler. And we're going to do this before we start the server. So and in this event handler, that's where all the magic is happening. So this event handler is called every time that a WebSocket message is coming in. And we're just going to check really quickly if it's a binary message and if it has a byte array of only 3 bytes, because we want to have the RGB of the color, so red, green, and blue, those are the 3 bytes are coming in. And we're going to hand over this RGB color to the RGB light on top of the device. And after that, we're going to broadcast this message to all other connected WebSocket clients. So finally, just going to show you really quickly what happens whenever you connect to the web server. So that happens over here with this handler. It's going to check, is it on the right URL? And then check, is this WebSocket yes or no? And this can be done by checking this header. And after that, we're just going to hand over the HTTP context to the WebSocket server. And the WebSocket server is just going to do all the magic for you. And if it's not a WebSocket request, we're just going to give all the HTML needed for the web application that we're running. Okay, so that's it. So let's dive right into it. And let's look at what this looks like in real life. So here we have the web browser. It's connected to the IP address of this small device. And let's refresh this one. And if I hit a color over here, you can see the RGB LED changing color. This happens very quickly. You can even slide over there and you can see the background is changing color. And the background is listening to the color that's being broadcasted by the WebSocket. That's fun, but let's see what happens if we open up multiple windows. I've that prepared over here. So we have four windows over here. And whenever I change the color, whatever window you like, you see all the clients instantly changing color. You can even do this more rapidly, and you can see how fast and how instant this is. So this is the very cool thing about WebSockets, and you can imagine how easy it can be to have like a smart sensor that's updating every second, so even faster than once per second, and have this connected up to WebSockets, so you can view them in the browser and see in real time what's going on. Okay, so that's the demo. I hope you enjoyed it. Looking forward to what you're going to build with WebSocket servers. And I hope to see you next time. Bye.